गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, टुडेज टॉपिक इज इलेक्ट्रॉन गेन एंथैल्पी और इलेक्ट्रॉन एफिनिटी। हाउ विल यू डिफाइन द इलेक्ट्रॉन गेन एंथैल्पी? मीन्स व्हेन द इलेक्ट्रॉन्स इज एडेड टू द न्यूट्रल गैसियस एटम इन इट्स ग्राउंड स्टेट, देन द एनर्जी इज रिलीज एंड इट विल फॉर्म the negative ions. This is anion. So this release of energy is called as electron gain enthalpy or electron affinity. The most stable state of an atom is the ground state. If the isolated gaseous atom is in excited state, then lesser energy will be released on adding an electron. So electron gain enthalpy of gaseous atom, that is calculated in their ground state. So the ground state and the isolated gaseous atoms, that has been included in this definition. Now, what is the unit of electron gain enthalpy? Electron volt per atom or kilojoule per mole. So, its value can be negative or positive. Positive in the case of endothermic reaction, means in which heat is absorbed, and negative in the case of exothermic reaction in which heat is released. So this depends on the nature of elements to which the electrons is to be added. Now next is successive electron gain enthalpy. Means the enthalpy change occurring when second, third and so on, these electrons are added to the uninegative ions. So this is called second ionization, electron gain enthalpy. When the electrons is added to negative ions, so there is a repulsion between the electrons and negative charge. To overcome this repulsion, the energy has to be supplied. Means the second and the further electron gain enthalpy that are positive, because the reaction becomes endothermic. Now we take one example. This is oxygen atom. The first electron gain enthalpy of oxygen atom is this, minus 141 kilojoule. Means here energy is released because electrons is add to the neutral isolated gaseous atom, so energy is released and oxygen having a negative charge, anion is formed. Now the second electron gain enthalpy of oxygen atom, when electrons is added to the negative ions, then there is a repulsion between the electrons and negative ions. So to overcome this repulsion, we have to supply the energy. So energy is absorbed in the form of heat. So here energy is absorbed, so this reaction is endothermic reaction and sign becomes positive. For endothermic reaction, sign is positive. Now next is the factor affecting electron gain enthalpy. First factor is atomic size. Means as the atomic size increases, distance between the nucleus and outermost shell, that is, increases. So the force of attraction between these two, that will be decreases. And electron affinity becomes less negative. So atomic size increases, electron enthalpy या electron gain enthalpy become less negative, means decreases. Now the second factor is nuclear charge. As the nuclear charge increases, then force of attraction between the nucleus and incoming electrons increases. So if the force of attraction increases, then electron affinity value become more negative. It means the size decreases. Nuclear charge increases, force of attraction increases, because the distance between the nucleus and outermost electrons decreases. So size decreases, electron affinity value become more negative. Now the next factor is electronic configuration. In the case of elements having half-filled and fully-filled configuration, that is more stable because of higher stability configuration. Because of higher stability, the energy has to be supplied to add an electron. So the value of electron gain enthalpy, that is positive. Here we take one example, noble gases. Second example of elements of group 15. In case of noble gases, the electronic configuration is fully filled, so it becomes stable. And in case of group 15 elements, here the configuration is half filled, so it is also stable. So the value of electron gain enthalpy, that is positive, because energy is applied to the electrons. Now the next is variation of electron affinity in the periodic table. First variation is variation along a period. On moving from left to right, the effective nuclear charge increases and the size decreases. So the added electrons on an average, that would be closer to the nucleus and strongly attracted by the nucleus. So the force of attraction increases and the value of electron gain enthalpy becomes more negative. One exceptional case is this: electron affinity of group 2 and 15 is low because of their stability of half-filled configuration. But the group 18 element has electron affinity positive because of completely filled valence shell. So its electron affinity value is positive. Here we have to supply energy to add the electrons. Now next is the variation along a group. On moving down a group, atomic size increases and the distance between the nucleus and incoming electrons, that will be increases. So the force of attraction between the nucleus and incoming electrons, that is decreases. If force of attraction decreases, it means the size increases, then electron affinity value becomes less negative. That becomes less negative. Here one exceptional case is this: the electron affinity of element of second period belonging to this nitrogen, oxygen and fluorine, that is less negative than the third period elements like phosphorus, sulfur and chlorine. Why? Because in case of element of second period, this nitrogen, oxygen and fluorine, the incoming electrons enter in the smaller n is equal to 2. value, means quantum number value is 2. So this shows greater force of attraction, repulsion by other electrons present in this level, where in the case of third period it enter into the large n is equal to 3 quantum number. So here the force of repulsion is much lesser as compared to elements of second period. So the chlorine has highest negative electron gain enthalpy in the periodic table. So due to the force of repulsion is greater in case of second period, and force of repulsion is much lesser in the case of third period. So second period elements have less negative value of electron affinity. Now one more question: which of the following will have the most negative electron affinity and which is the least electron affinity in this element? Phosphorus, sulfur, chlorine and fluorine. So here first of all we have to find out the group number and period number. Arrange in this form: group number 15 phosphorus is present here, group 16 sulfur is present here in the third period, and group 17 fluorine is present in second period, and chlorine is present in third period. So in this case, along a period electron affinity increases, but down the group electron affinity decreases. But the elements of second period like fluorine that has lesser electron affinity as compared to third period elements because of smaller size and greater repulsion. So electron affinity value that become less. So the chlorine is more negative electron gain enthalpy, and phosphorus has less negative electron gain enthalpy. So most negative electron affinity is of chlorine and least electron affinity is of phosphorus atom. Now one more question is: electron gain enthalpy of group 15 elements that is highly negative, because in group 15 elements electronic configuration is ns2np3, means this is exactly half filled configuration. So half filled electronic configuration, it becomes stable, so energy has to be supplied to add an electron. So the value of electron gain enthalpy that is highly positive, because here energy is to be supplied. So this reaction is exothermic reaction or endothermic. This is endothermic reaction because energy is absorbed during the reaction, so it become positive value. Now next is: why the electron gain enthalpy of noble gases has large positive value? Because in case of noble gases, means group 18 elements, configuration is ns2np6. So here valence shell is completely filled, means s is also filled and p is also filled, so there is no need to add and remove the electron in this configuration. But if still we add an electron to this configuration, the electrons enter in the next higher principal quantum level, so it leads to the high stability configuration. This become unstable, highly unstable configuration. For this, a large amount of energy is required, so the electron gain enthalpy of noble gases that have a large positive value, because it is already fully filled, and if the electrons are added, then it goes to next higher principal quantum level, so the configuration become unstable. So its electron gain enthalpy value of noble gases that has large positive value. Now the next question is, why the electron gain enthalpy of halogen is highly negative? Because in case of electron gain enthalpy of halogen family belongs to group 17 and its configuration is NS2NP5. So if we add the one electrons in the p orbital, then it becomes 6. So its configuration become NS2NP6. This is fully filled configuration. So to attain the stable noble gas electronic configuration, they have very high tendency to attract 10 electrons. So their electron gain enthalpy is highly negative. Because after adding one electrons, it becomes stable configuration. So here energy is release, so it becomes negative. So this reaction is exothermic reaction. Now next question is, arrange the following elements in the order of decreasing electron gain enthalpy: boron, carbon, nitrogen and oxygen. Because nitrogen has positive electron gain enthalpy, and while the other atoms, boron, carbon and oxygen, that have negative electron gain enthalpy. Because size decreases on moving from boron to carbon, carbon to oxygen, so the electron gain enthalpy becomes more and more negative from boron to carbon and carbon to oxygen. So the overall decreasing order of electron gain enthalpy is nitrogen, boron, carbon and oxygen. Now one more question. Electron gain enthalpy of beryllium and magnesium is positive. Why? Because they have fully filled S subshell and they have no tendency to accept an additional electrons. So the energy has to be supplied if an extra electrons has to be added to the much higher energy p orbital of the valence shell. That's why the electron gain enthalpy of beryllium and magnesium are positive. So all these are the questions based on electron gain enthalpy or electron affinity. This topic is very important for your exam. So thank you, students.